Today's video is for anyone who experiences any fatigue, low energy, indigestion, bloating. If any of these sound like you, watch this whole video and I'm gonna share my 6 favorite foods for gut health. Hey guys, it's Dr. Mona, and in today's video, I wanna talk all about gut health. This is a really trending term right now. Everyone's focused on gut health, and one of the main reasons is there's a lot of research that's being done. It's actually somewhat of a newer topic that we're discovering and learning more about, and everyone just wants to do whatever they can to ensure that their digestion is good, their gut health is good, because we're learning so much about how your gut can affect every part of your body. It can affect your brain. There's the brain-gut relationship. It can affect your energy. There's leaky gut that can even get into your bloodstream and, affect autoimmune diseases and so much. So it's kind of cool that we're all discovering how important food is and diet and gut health. And I wanted to share some really easy, seamless tips because I also feel like it can get a little bit confusing with like probiotics and prebiotics and supplements. And I think there's a really natural approach to try to fix it and really optimize it. So that's what today's video is all about. So all the food in this video I got from Thrive Market. You probably see me talk about Thrive a lot. I like getting all of my superfoods there because number one, the prices are just much less expensive. I've actually like done price comparisons when I order on like Instacart from Whole Foods or Erewhon or wherever else I'm grocery shopping from, and I compare the prices to Thrive and it's the exact same brands for less. So that's one huge motivator for me. I also love that it gets delivered because I like having everything delivered to my door. I also love that I can get everything else there, cleaning supplies, whatever. It's just, easier to all come in one. I will put my link for Thrive below this video. If you use the link, you can get a 30-day free trial membership and you can get 25% off your first order. Okay, so here are the foods that I wanted to share for gut health. I purposely picked like really simple, kind of everyday go-to foods because I wanted to make this as least complicated as possible. I don't like when I find recipes and things that are just gonna take a lot of my time or just be a little bit intimidating. I feel like that stops me and maybe other people from wanting to like make a change. So I wanted to go kind of with the basics and just share some easy foods. So let's start with cereal, this Sprouted Granola, because I love cereal. I'm like the cereal queen. I think you guys, if you've watched my videos, know that I actually don't even keep it in the house because I genuinely can't contain myself. I love it that much and I'll eat the whole box in a day. But traditionally speaking, cereal is not very healthy. It's processed. The additives, especially in the US versus like, Europe or other countries, we add in a lot of preservatives and things to make it last on the shelf for 3 years or whatever else it's doing. There's a lot of sugar added. So just traditionally speaking, cereal is not something I recommend. But there was one cereal that I found that is very healthy, can really help your gut. And I thought it would be cool to share because it's just good to have as like an emergency food and it's delicious. So this one is, the brand is Go Raw and it's Sprouted Granola. So anything you see that's sprouted is automatically gonna be better for your gut. Basically, sprouting is the process of soaking something in water. True sprouting can take days where you soak it, like take it from the water, hang it. There's like a lot that goes into it. Don't quote me on that. I don't really go through the like 3-day sprouting, but I like to soak grains, beans, anything like that in water for at least a day. It basically gets rid of this outer enzyme and helps it get digested better in our gut. So it's almost like you could say you're pre-digesting it by sprouting it. Now, soaking it in water for a day, some people don't like because what if you last minute want to eat something and you don't want to have to soak it? Buying foods that are pre-sprouted can be an amazing hack for this. And this one is really, really good. It's a cocoa crunch. I'm gonna read you the ingredients because it's super clean. Sprouted buckwheat groats. By the way, buckwheat groats are an undiscovered, I feel like, I'm sure many of you watching this know what they are, but many people don't. I didn't for a long time. It's a fruit that tastes like a grain. It has the same consistency as a grain. So you can use it in like acai bowls. It food combines perfectly. It's really, really cool. So I love buckwheat groats. Sprouted buckwheat groats, dates, sprouted sunflower seeds, sprouted sesame seeds, unsulfured coconut, hemp seeds, cacao, vanilla extract, and sea salt. It's like the most incredible ingredients. The only sugar in here is dates, which is a great natural sweetener, low glycemic index. I'll show you what it looks like. You can eat it as granola. You can eat it as cereal. I ate some last night as cereal. Like I said, it's in the house. I was like, okay, please don't eat the whole bag because you have to film this video. So that's probably the only reason I contain myself. But this is what it looks like. take a little bite. Mmm, so good. I'm gonna put it back in the bag because it's my cereal, so. Tip number one. The next thing I want to share is apple cider vinegar, which you can also tell that I use a lot of because it's empty. So the first thing I love about apple cider vinegar is that it's got antifungal, antibacterial, and antiviral properties. I think that's really cool and unique. So it can help, you know, with your immunity, obviously preventing you from getting any kind of infection. Not everything, but it can definitely help as much as we can naturally. But I also think it's really cool because it helps our body produce HCl. So HCl, hydrochloric acid, is actually like an enzyme we produce and release when we need to break down food. And a lot of times digestive enzymes will be HCl, so you can go and buy this. But if you want to try the natural route and not have to worry about taking more supplements, this could be a great start. Adding apple cider vinegar, you know, with meals, maybe in like a drink, you could add it into your salad dressing. Honestly, if you can throw it into foods and just kind of have it mixed in there, it could be a great tip. So check that out. I like to buy it raw and unfiltered. This one, it's like With the Mother is what it's called. You can see it almost looks like a little bit cloudy. And you can just shake it up before you use it. If you don't like the taste of apple cider vinegar, I recommend keeping it in the refrigerator and adding some lemon. That really helps kind of kick that taste. Think about like a shot of alcohol. If it's warm, it tastes more disgusting. But when it's really, really cold, you don't taste it as much. It's kind of the same with apple cider vinegar. It's like take a shot of one, take a shot of the other. So next I want to talk about seaweed. So seaweed's so healthy for so many reasons. You know, it's got a lot of minerals. It comes from the sea. Like there's just so many benefits to it. I personally hate the taste of seaweed. Even when I have sushi, I actually ask for it with soy paper because I don't like it. But if you like it, amazing. I'm jealous of you. So embrace that and have more seaweed. You can buy it as a snack. This one I really like because it's lime flavored. So the lime kind of takes off that seaweed fishy taste of it. I like seaweed because for gut health, it can help you produce more healthy gut bacteria. And we know bacteria is bad, but we also have a lot of good bacteria. And if we're taking antibiotics, sometimes if we're doing a lot of cleanses and like, there's so many different reasons we could have a low amount of good bacteria. So doing just natural things or eating natural foods that help us produce it can always be really helpful. So just for a snack, I like these little tips because you can throw this in. It's not anything major. It's just, oh, like instead of snacking on chips, let's snack on some lime seaweed. Next, I wanted to share mung beans. So as you can see, again, these are sprouted. Mung beans, like any other bean you could buy, sprouted, not sprouted. This brand True Roots is pretty good because they have a lot of grains and legumes pre-sprouted. They have a quinoa that's sprouted too. Mung beans are amazing because they're very, very easy on your stomach to digest. I actually discovered mung beans when I was doing this cleanse called Panchakarma. This is an Ayurvedic cleanse that's pretty intense. It's like a 7-day process. You go in for 3 hours a day, right in the morning. It's like lymphatic drainage massage and like oils like up your nose and on your body, and you can only eat certain things, and it's all about like digestive. I mean, it's a full detox, but a huge focus was digestion. And I went because I was just dealing with severe bloating. So one of the rules during this cleanse is you can literally only eat red lentils, white rice, and mung beans. And I was like, I don't think I've ever had mung beans. I've never really had it growing up. So I discovered it, and this is just goes back in Ayurvedic science years and years ago. These are things that are so easily digested on the stomach. In fact, we weren't even allowed to have brown rice because brown rice is too much fiber, and sometimes too much fiber can be harder on your stomach. It depends. Usually great, but for this cleanse, it was like white rice, mung beans, and red lentils. So this is a really good one. The whole week when I was eating it, I wasn't bloated. It was really gentle on my stomach. You can just boil them. They're kind of just like, you don't really notice them. You could mix them into a salad, eat them warm or cold. Just like an easy one to add. Think of it like quinoa. You could do the exact same things with mung beans as you can quinoa. And they've got 10 grams of protein and 1/4 cup. So that's just a benefit there. So the last food I want to talk about are organic red kidney beans. So I picked beans. There's a lot of different beans you can try that could really help. I like red kidney beans. Now, the whole point of this is fiber. So fiber can be really helpful. Obviously, I was just saying too much fiber can be a little hard on your stomach, but that was a very intense cleanse. Generally speaking, fiber is so important, so essential to gut health. There's insoluble fiber and there's soluble fiber. A lot of foods tend to have a little bit of both, but you can really look up, if you could even just go on Google and search like insoluble fiber sources, soluble fiber sources, And you can eat more of one depending on what your digestive issues are. Insoluble fiber tends to be really good for constipation because it doesn't absorb any water. So it just kind of helps things pass along, which, you know, if you're tightening up and you're not going to the bathroom, and you can think of foods that are high in insoluble fiber. If you add water to them, they don't absorb it. Like, so if I took this bag of beans and I put it in a bowl and added water, it's not like they would get mushy or like absorb it or turn into like a jelly substance. They would just sit there and, you know, you could just dump the water out and they're still hard. So that's how you know if it's insoluble fiber. Soluble fiber will absorb the water and you'll see a difference in the texture. So like oatmeal or chia seeds, different things like that. So you can go and see which has which one. And soluble fiber would be good if you have the opposite problem of constipation. So if you're going to the bathroom way too much, which could even be temporary, it could be maybe you're just like irregular, that could be something to look into adding in. But overall, both are really important. So the last thing I want to talk about is not a food, but it's kind of a fermentation kit. So before I get into this, I just want to talk about fermentation in general. I'm sure you guys have heard about fermented foods being good for you, things like sauerkraut or kombucha. Definitely look into your specific diet before like going overboard on a million like processed fermented foods. I would make sure you're trying to find things that are naturally fermented. That's always gonna be better for your gut. You can even see it on the label if it says naturally fermented. That's kind of a telltale sign. Like some pickles are naturally fermented. Some of them just like throw in vinegar and it's not the same process. So the process of fermentation, just in a nutshell, I won't get entirely into that in this video, is basically microorganisms like bacteria and yeast, they take the sugar in a food and break it down into lactic acid. Then the lactic acid is used to basically almost preserve food but prevent bacteria and yeast overgrowth. So that's why when you see people saying fermented foods can help with bacterial overgrowth, yeast, kind of like we mentioned, that's the point of it. So this is the Fermented Vegetable Master. So this is basically a kit where you can ferment your own things at home. This is not something you have to do. Like I said, there's so many great options of foods that are already fermented, but I thought it would be cool to give you guys the option for anyone who wants to try it. Some people literally like it as a hobby. It's kind of like pickling or making pickles at home. If you buy this, they give you like a 6-step like pamphlet, tell you exactly what to do. It could take like a week, 2 weeks. Maybe you can do it on a weekend and just make it like a project, but I thought it would just be a cool option to add in since fermented food is so great for the gut. Okay, before I end this video, I just wanna share a few tips that are not food related for gut health. I truly think, and I've seen, that gut health is affected really by stress, sleep, inflammation, and food. These are like four factors that can just play such a huge role. If you're not sleeping, studies have shown your appetite literally changes. When you wake up and you haven't slept enough, you actually crave more higher fat, unhealthy foods. Like they've actually seen the difference by just getting, I think the study showed like a 1 hour difference in more sleep and the different kinds of foods people would crave. So if you're not getting enough sleep, you know, you're going to crave unhealthy foods. You might eat things that are more processed and higher in fat. That could affect your gut microbiome. Stress is huge. I mean, the best example I like to give for this is picture a situation where you're really, really nervous for something. You usually have to go to the bathroom right before. This is super common. So the gut-brain relationship is just very, very real. And inflammation, I mean, it affects the gut. It can affect the leaky gut. Inflammation affects the whole body. So no matter what ailment I was talking about, I would say inflammation is an issue. I mean, even throughout pharmacy school, we studied disease state management, and pretty much the leading cause of every single disease state was inflammation. So it was always something that we were taught to counsel patients on and to try to reduce, whether naturally or sometimes, you know, through medication. So just keep that in mind too for gut health. It's always good to tackle things from different angles. These are all natural angles, and, you know, try to prevent before you have to treat. I hope you guys like this video. Check out the description. I will link every specific food item and this cute little kit. And I will also put my link for Thrive Market so that if you want to check it out, you can get a 30-day free trial membership. See if you like it. I love it, so I think you will too. If you have any questions on any of these specific foods, leave it in the comments. And please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.